Welcome, everybody, to another episode of Mr. McHale's Manor of Mischief, Magic, and Mystery, the podcast where we talk about music, the occult, and just day-to-day life. I am your host, Andrew McHale, and welcome to the 6M Podcast. And we're back. Thank you, everybody, for tuning in, and welcome to episode 41 of the 6M Podcast. Today, of all days, we are presenting part 16 of the Lizard and the Wizard quarantine saga, where I partner up with the partner in crime, the co-conspirator, the lizard.
Whoop whoop. Sorry.
Welcome, everybody. Welcome the lizard to the manor.
I'm her.
How are you doing today, lizard?
Oh, I'm grand.
In this part 16 quarantine.
16 quarantine. I like things that rhyme.
16 quarantine saga where we basically have been doing episodes as like a status update in the quarantine since March. We do it weekly or bi-weekly, basically. Whenever we can fit it in, no pun intended. And we've taken some weeks off, but hey, 16, sweet 16.
Quarantine 16, Andrew 32.
I would say it's a bittersweet 16. Why? Because as of today, the 8th of December in the year of our Lord and Savior 2020.
King James.
We are potentially entering part two of the lockdown that we've seen since March. And I'm only saying that because that's what the general consensus is, even though you and I don't believe it.
Suck a dick. You shouldn't have me comment on this. It'll be a rant. It's no good.
No shit.
Yeah, you don't want me to talk about that. Oh, hell nah. It was supposed to start several weeks. It was like November, dude, and now it's December. You know, the time flies.
But being that we live in Illinois, our governor has been wishy-washy on extending the lockdowns that you see in California right now, where everybody's stuck at home, apparently.
Because he's been wishy-washy because he has no authority to do it because it's unconstitutional, and he knows people in Illinois are going to be like, go fuck yourself.
But are we sure about that?
I mean, I think there's a lot more people here that would do that in the fucking Midwest than people in California.
No offense. Sure, the people outside of Cook County, Illinois, for sure, they would probably.
Yeah, but think about all the Southsiders, Sox fan people, like in fucking the South suburbs. Joliet, fucking Orland Park. Those people are not having it.
I guess we'll have to find out as time goes on. Since the last episode, I believe, the 1 year episode of the podcast, I kind of took some time off to sit here and think and ponder on how to execute the podcast. But another thing that happened during that time period was Thanksgiving.
Turkey Day.
How was your Thanksgiving?
Shit. So you shouldn't have me recording this like late in the evening. I get weirder. How was Turkey Day?
Yeah.
It's pretty good.
What were you thankful for this year?
Yeah, you know what? No one asked me, did they?
I don't think anybody even.
Dude, we were supposed to do that when we went to bed, tell each other what we're thankful for. I don't think we ever
actually did. Says who?
Did we do it? I can't even fucking remember.
You tried. I just.
Did I fall asleep?
Ignored you.
Oh. Oh, no, I did tell you. I told you that I was thankful for you being Steve Martin to my what's his face in Planes, Trains, and Automobiles.
John Candy.
Yeah, but what's his name in there in the movie? Whatever.
I
like his name, but yeah, you're my Steve Martin to my John Candy in Planes, Trains, and Automobiles this Thanksgiving because I felt sort of displaced and like I had nowhere to go and we were fighting like the days leading up to Thanksgiving.
As most people do.
My dad died in September and so like my whole family's like a fucking just displaced bunch of vagabonds now that doesn't care about holidays, and so I had no Thanksgiving and we were fighting, and so I was worried that you were even gonna like take me with to your family's Thanksgiving, and then you did, and it was just like that moment in Planes, Trains, and Automobiles when he realizes John Candy has no family because his wife has been dead, and then they carry his fucking like trunk down his street.
Spoiler alert.
I don't know, I'm documenting that, whatever.
Spoiler alert for any of those who haven't seen Planes, Trains, and Automobiles.
Who hasn't?
By now.
Yeah, you know, I don't think you can do spoiler alerts for a movie that was made in 1989.
I guess only the comment section will tell. I don't know. So whatever. Given that you've already started talking about Planes, Trains,
Sorry,
and Automobiles.
You asked me what I was thankful for. That was the only thing I was thankful for was you taking me in. Half an orphan. The other half that's left is woof.
Ugh. This got real heavy real quick.
Anyway, Thanksgiving was nice.
Yeah.
I thought that was nice though. I was John Candy. And he's like super like dumb in that movie. Not dumb, just like silly and does dumb shit like me. And Steve Martin's so serious like you. It reminds me of us.
So for those of you that haven't seen it, go watch Planes, Trains, and Automobiles. It's becoming a Thanksgiving tradition for us because there isn't really that many Thanksgiving movies, and it's a good one.
We watch it every year.
Yeah.
I like it. It's heartwarming and weird.
Is it a John Hughes movie?
Yes.
That's another reason.
And we made my mom watch it this year.
And she liked it.
She did. She's like, I can't believe I never saw that.
Oh, my God.
Oh, my God.
How was the food this Thanksgiving?
The food was good. We went to your family's.
Oh.
Delicious per usual. However, I was missing my favorite Assyrian dish from your grandmother, which I have forgiven her for because I was never really mad, but I missed it.
You know, people are going to call us grandmother killers.
No.
In the comments for going to the house for Thanksgiving.
Oh. Oh, yeah. I'm over COVID. You can believe whatever you want. I don't have. No one cares what I think. I'm over COVID.
I mean, so am I. But hey, today the executive order was signed that Americans will get the vaccine before anybody else in the world. Given that you want a vaccine.
Bro, we've had the fucking flu shot for like 60 plus years and we still have the flu every year and that's a vaccine. So
but this is gonna fix everything.
Yeah, no, and that's cool, but I would just rather get sick than inject myself with things.
Yeah, same. Well, the thing to think about is if you are in the situation in your life where you absolutely need to get it, I am not saying that you shouldn't get it, but as long as you have a choice, you shouldn't get it. Pretty much.
Well, people make their own decisions.
Exactly.
It's their life.
But I'm saying if...
Their body, none of my fucking business.
Exactly. But what I'm saying is, it should be a choice. And if it's not necessary, I wouldn't do it. Because obviously, with these things, they do come with, you know, certain side effects. Whether now, later, when you're older... You never know.
Well,
nobody
just,
ever knows.
It's just like we were scared of COVID at the beginning because no one had a lot of information about what would happen. Now it's the vaccine and you don't, they've done studies and tests and stuff, but no one knows long term what could happen. So,
but basically,
no thanks.
All I'm saying is that at least now people have the option to take one.
True.
And
yeah, I mean, that's good. And also that will make a lot of people, I think, feel probably better about the whole thing. So that's good. That means things can start opening up. That means older people can get the fuck out of their houses because I think my mother alone now is going to lose her fucking mind soon. So yeah.
Yeah. And that's something I've seen online that's been debated a bunch, and it's just like my perspective is hey, at least now you have the option.
At least it's an option. Yeah. And if it makes you feel better and then you can start going out, then that's great. Exactly. Everyone should just be responsible for their own selves, just like in flu season or whatever. You know, it's out there.
But they are responsible whatever. Whilst thinking of people close to them.
Yeah, you cough and sneeze into your elbow.
Or if you're feeling sick, you don't fucking see your grandma, you know?
Straight up. If you have one.
Yeah.
Mine died in July.
All right. So.
Sorry.
And that's not COVID related, by the way. So Oreos came out with the new Oreo that we've been vibing out this Thanksgiving season.
So let's tell the story of the Oreos.
Story?
Yeah, I went to Walgreens one day for something totally unrelated, and I saw there was a holiday special Oreo package.
When isn't there one?
What the fuck flavor is it? Gingerbread?
Is it like ginger doodle?
It's like gingerbread cookies with cream in the middle, but the cream in the middle has like little like candy cane sprinkles in it.
Wait, is it candy cane
sprinkles? I don't fucking know, but it's so good. They might just be red sprinkles. Like those crystal looking ones.
I don't think there's
no mint in it. So it's just got to be the red.
It's sprinkles. Oreo's gingerbread sandwich cookies.
Yeah. And they don't put it. It's like not in the normal size Oreo package. It's in the special edition, like the smaller fucking package. So you don't get as many. So I bought the pack. Then we ate it promptly in like 2 days. And then now every time I've come back to Walgreens.
I've noticed.
I look.
Yeah.
That I just bought the last one.
Yo.
You know what I told the cashier on my way out? This girl, and I was like, hey, don't ever buy these. And she was like, what are you talking about? I was like, don't. I was like, you're going to regret it. You're going to get fat like me. You're going to ruin your life.
And then she was like.
I mean, she was and I were like the same size. It's not like you were like fat.
Okay.
It's just a warning.
Is there a double stuffed version of this Oreo cookie?
I'm certain there is not, but
It says
what?
Oh, there's niacin in this.
I don't care what's in it.
Red 40.
It's the best cookie I've ever had in my whole life.
It is pretty good.
Wait, didn't I say this on the podcast in March about the fucking carrot cake Oreos? I'm a fucking liar.
It's all the same.
They are. These are similar to the carrot cake, but better.
But better.
Better.
So I'm just on the Oreo website, just looking at Oreos now because I'm. There's a What's lemon that? Oreo?
Oh, yeah. Those have been around for a long time. Gross. Diane likes those. What's that one on the left? Those are carrot cakes?
Yeah.
What's the one on the right?
Caramel coconut.
Disgusting. And I like coconut. It's caramel.
Typical.
By the way.
Typical.
How do you say caramel? Say caramel?
Do you see what I fucking deal with?
Do you really fucking say caramel? What's the pink one?
Don't you mean punk? Don't you mean pink? Fucking asshole.
Mm-hmm.
Anyways,
what is the pink one?
Dead air.
Is that a unicorn? Yeah, I dead aired you because
this,
I don't.
This birthday cake Oreos.
What's the one all the way to the left of that one?
This?
No, up to the left.
You know,
I can't fucking read that far to
this
the left. Yeah,
it's just red coloring.
Oh, disgusting!
Dumbass.
Go fuck yourself.
I will.
I can't read that far. I have poor vision.
Poor vision. Poor lizard.
It's nice. If you ever stole my glasses and my contacts, you would know that you would basically be disabling me and then I'd be fucked.
Great. Hillary? All you gotta do is take her glasses. There you go.
I store extra contacts in my
great. Bed. So another new Thanksgiving tradition that we've taken on in the house. Is live streaming train videos.
So
the lizard hates the word
we. First of all, I would say I.
Basically, it's become a new tradition.
No.
for me. Because what usually happens is every day we wake up and I do a bunch of shit to just kind of get the house and the working space kind of tidy. And then I'll take my pills and then I'll,
old man.
I'll get my coffee.
Do I sing my Folgers jingle?
I'll get my coffee and then, you know, start sitting down and looking at news and whatnot. And I'll usually have the news playing and sometimes I'll have the fireplace going and maybe even a little blanket.
Ooh.
So with what's been happening the past however many weeks, it just became too much to like sit there and try and like work or create whilst listening to the news. So one day, out of just pure stress, I turned on like some sort of like YouTube live stream video. And it's just like a point of view camera of like a train going through Norway. And I just like kept it on for the whole day. And
it's like a GoPro thing, right? Like they just strap it on like a fucking train or a monorail or whatever.
It's like a Twitch stream of like someone driving a train through Norway. And I kept it on the whole day. And then all of a sudden, like every recommended video on our YouTube is like live stream trains. And I love it.
You single-handedly ruined our fucking YouTube recommendations.
It's so good.
Everything is live stream train, live stream monorail, live stream Tokyo traffic. I want to fucking die. It sounds it fucking like the Nordic like ones in the, it's like snowy and there's a train or a monorail and you hear that's what it fucking sounds like all day.
It's because I'm going places.
And I work on another floor in this house. And every time I walk like down the stairs, all of a sudden I can already hear it.
Love it.
I can't stand it. And then you watch the Tokyo, like the live stream of just like traffic in downtown Tokyo. It's like sirens all the time. Like somebody's fucking dying.
Yeah, like when there's some, like, if I hear the ambulance in Tokyo, like, sometimes I'll go to you and be like, someone's going to the hospital.
Dude, sometimes
right
I
now.
Think it's outside of our house.
That's what it is.
It's terrible.
The world is outside of our house.
To be totally serious, watching those makes me so nervous.
What does it make you nervous?
I mean, like, some things. What about, you should talk about my survival skill, you know?
Eating Oreos.
But you're gonna say eating cock.
Yeah. No.
I was gonna see my Folgers. The best part of waking up is Andrew's cock in your mouth. What?
There you go, people.
Sorry.
Better get you some hot Folgers injection coming up. Soon, go get vaccinated and come on down.
Anyway.
So yeah, that's my new thing. The live streams of like cityscapes and whatnot, because
it's terrible.
I haven't been there in a long time and it feels nice.
No, it doesn't feel nice to feel like you're strapped on the front of a train driving through the Arctic.
I like it.
Like maybe if it was inside the cabin and it was,
it
like
is
warm.
Inside the cabin.
Yep. No, it's not. That's like, no, that's outside.
The camera is.
Yeah, that's what I mean. And that's what you hear is the outside noises.
It's like on the dashboard. Don't be dramatic.
Yes, but it's not soothing in any way because it feels like you like in one of those old cartoons, like somebody strapped you to the front of the fucking train and that's what you would hear.
Maybe that comforts me. Thought about that. Well, I needed it, okay, because...
It's fine. It's pretty. Listen, if I could hear it without the noises, mm-hmm. I think I wouldn't mind. Like, or if I could watch it without the noises, I think I wouldn't mind it. But it's like the constant.
Also, what if something happens on the live stream?
I mean,
something crazy.
You don't want to see a train accident.
What if it derails? Or
yeah, you don't want to watch that.
What if all of a sudden there's like bombings in the cityscapes.
You also don't want to watch that.
I feel like I'm like right there. I get the news right there. And I sound the alarm. Well, listen, I needed it, okay, because the week after Thanksgiving, basically, pretty much Black Friday onward, was fucking hell for me.
Yeah.
Trying to navigate.
It's because you went to Walmart and you got trampled by all those people. No, just kidding.
He's got to get him.
Did we watch that last? What was that?
We watched it every year except for this year.
We should.
Here's to you, Dad. No, basically, I don't know. Like anyone who's listening to this probably knows of my doings in Serpents US. And, you know, we protested Black Friday last year. And I thought that was very becoming of me. And then this year, I'm like, oh, everything shut down. And this is like the year we should probably be doing something. But I stuck to my guns and I said, fuck Black Friday, protest it, whatever. And then Saturday, was it Small Business Saturday? I was like, nah, not ready yet. Cyber Monday, whatever. Pretty much since Black Friday, I've been like scrambling to get this merch store that I've been trying to get together for like the past month. Surprise everybody, I've been working on a merch store for a while, and then I was like, there's no need, nobody's buying anything right now because of the virus and all this shit, nobody's working.
You sound like so, that guy.
Get what you're entitled to
with so, the uncertainty of the virus.
With the uncertainty of the virus.
I'm sorry I interrupted you, but I couldn't.
Yeah, it took me a while to like, because keep in mind I'm doing all the other things pertaining to the band. So, you know, website design, SEO, graphic design, and e-commerce shit, I'm like not very used to. I'm used to just kind of putting merch up on like Bandcamp and just selling. So literally, like for a week and some days, I was working day to night trying to get this merch store together with all this new merch, which finally, it came to a point. I think it was like last week for Bandcamp Friday. We missed that. Whoops. Sorry, everybody. But it came to the point where I just said, fuck the website. I'm just going to throw this shit on Bandcamp, get this thing going. So I orchestrated a t-shirt drop, hoodie drop, long sleeves drop, you know, face masks, sweatpants, koozies, baby clothes, kids t-shirt. Like I did a huge merch drop, and that train really helped calm me down because it was kind of a hellish week, and I think you could attest to that. Can you not?
Yes, it was.
What was I most worried about?
Oh.
Letting who down?
Letting your fans down.
Yeah.
Obviously. Yeah.
So I was really, 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 really beating myself up for about all those days.
You're very hard on yourself. It's frustrating for me because you don't need to be.
It's frustrating for me too. So... You know, the kicker was, though, here's the, see, right now it just sounds like I'm just like, man, waited and it just didn't work. And what happened on Black Friday? Why could I not get the website and everything going?
Well, our internet went out like the bitch that it is, because our internet is truly the biggest whore in this house. There's some hoes in this house. Boom. Hoes. Boom. Sorry, I had to. Boom. No, literally, our internet is the most temperamental bitch living here.
But it's
she's been, her own entity.
It's been pretty steady.
Well, since we got it fixed.
Yes.
But it's weird. Every fucking time they have to come out, it's like a few months and then the whole shit goes to shit. They can't fix it over the phone, whatever. Every time they come out, it's either in the box on our house or the box at the top of the fucking pole by our house. And they're like, it makes no sense.
And it's
this
all,
whole piece was broken and disconnected. Makes no sense. So weird. And I'm like, who's fucking disabling our internet?
Hillary.
Hillary.
And it's every provider. It's not just one provider. It's
Comcast
like
gave up on us.
Every company we've gotten so far.
Literally,
has been,
Comcast quit us.
Yeah.
Because the internet would never work. They sent out like what? Like 10 technicians?
It was about 14.
It would
visits.
Never work. And eventually I was like, what are you going to do to keep our business? And they were like, we don't want it anymore.
Yeah.
We can't fix it. And I was like, oh, this is what this feels like to have your internet company quit on you.
Because they know you need them. They don't need you.
Yeah, it's fucking bullshit. They used
Comcast.
To care. Do you know, internet companies and cable, like, they used to care.
Mm-hmm.
Like, to keep your business. They don't anymore because they know we need it. Like, they can't. There's
especially,
nothing we can do. Like, it's not like we could pull it out of our asses or like borrow cable from like a neighbor or like whatever, log into shit. Like,
there's ways.
We need to have the internet.
There's
and especially
ways.
Now because everybody's working from home.
But the worst part about it is so I'm like, yeah, let's get this merch store up today. Fuck all this bullshit. Then the internet goes out. And I'm like, all right. Let's try and figure this out another way. Let's use the hotspot from my phone. None of my phone doesn't work for days. So usually, you know, if your internet connection is poor, your phone would usually switch over, whatever. I had no phone service and we had no internet. And I was trying to orchestrate this, I don't know, however many item merch drop. So needless to say, I lost my shit.
Just a little bit, multiple times.
You know, there was a couple days where, you know, I would have to just honestly just scream from frustration because it just became so much. Because honestly, literally everything that we do, like Four Serpents, always comes with like horrible, horrible obstacles. And most of the time, it's outside of my control, which that's why I get so mad, probably, because it's not in my control. And I feel like it's a bad representation of us, of our business, whatever. And this was no different. And a fucking, you know, screaming my head off just to the void, which is not like me. And then I lose my voice. So we didn't have internet, didn't have phone service. I missed cyber whatever weekend. And then you're telling me, oh, it's cyber week. So I'm like, okay. So we got internet back Tuesday or Wednesday. So I'm like, all right, I'm still going to try to do a podcast. I'm still going to try and bust out this merch store for Bandcamp Friday. And then things happen and I ended up losing my shit and then I lost my voice. Literally, I had no voice.
Wait. Did you lose your shit and your voice twice? Yeah.
What?
You lost your shit and your voice two times.
In 1 week.
Yeah. I don't think you specified that this was a separate occurrence.
Yeah. So when it came time to do a podcast, I asked the podcast Facebook group, if I should just do one and fight through it. And I'm like, nah. So nobody really said, do the podcast. So I didn't do it.
Nah.
And then I think, what was it? Saturday, the day after Bandcamp Friday, we got the merch store up.
Smirch.
And very excited about that. However, I do need to figure out a way to host the merch outside of Bandcamp, which is a whole nother endeavor that I do not have the patience for right now because I want to write music, y'all.
That would be good.
So to celebrate, the merch drop.
Good time. Come on.
To celebrate the merch drop, we started to get a little chaotic in the house.
Did we?
Whole lot of...
I'm sorry. The whole last week and a half was such a blur because you were such a crabby bitch for so long and then I don't remember. It's like I blocked it out.
It's because everything that I try and do comes with a cost.
It really does. Okay, so what did we do? I don't remember.
So one thing that got me through those nights while all that shit was happening is I'll occasionally like to torture the lizard with some weird YouTube videos after dinner. Yeah,
and shockingly, we're not talking about the train ones that he plays all day.
Yeah.
There's more.
There's more.
There's more. There's always more.
There's a whole lot more.
Always more.
One thing that got me through this hell week was, especially without having a voice, I needed someone to sing for me. I needed to speak for me. I need someone to tell the lizard that I'm simply the best.
Better than all the rest.
There's no other person that I'd rather use as my voice than the legendary saxophone player from the hit movie Lost Boys and the Tina Turner band, Mr. Tim Capello.
Whoop, whoop! Who doesn't love a Tim Capello? I don't know if people know who that is, but...
Basically, if you've ever seen the movie The Lost Boys, there's that scene with the hip-thrusting, oiled-up, shirtless saxophone man...
On stage.
Singing... I still believe.
I still believe. And he does this motion while he's playing his sax with his hips.
I still believe.
I should have asked. I'm positive the man either has to have had or needs a hip replacement.
Did you just assume his gender?
He's a man.
He's a man.
I don't give a shit. It looks like he needs a fucking hip. You should see this hip motion that he does. I can't even do it. It's only one side, I think. And then he oils up his ass.
Yeah.
Or he wears shiny skin-colored unitard under his black...
Well, we're talking later.
...leather thumb. Yeah, I shouldn't give it away. Just YouTube dive into Tim Capello and you will not be... upset that you did.
No. You'll be very, very pleased.
So yeah, we've been watching Tim Capello.
We've been watching
videos on YouTube and you've been torturing me with it, even though I like it, but you fucking will come up to bed and fucking play it and then you'll dance into bed. I still believe. And then you come in with your hip thrust. So for Christmas.
Wait.
What?
What else do I torture you with?
Wide Putin.
We've been watching cyber goth videos.
Don't even talk about the night I danced to cyber goth music for an hour in a Mandalorian mask in front of you with my tits out. Yeah. That was not good. The fact that you have videos, we can't ever break up.
Yeah.
So yeah, I have a problem.
Tit Mandalorian cyber goth videos.
A full Mando mask.
With
full head.
With
it was so dumb.
With an axe in your hand.
Yes, and an axe. And I'm throwing those fake cyber goth crystal balls. I'm crushing them. Oh shit, I just scared the dog. Sorry.
So
I get into that shit.
Cyber goth videos, D-Devils. Six centuries ago.
It's such an aggressive form of dancing.
Huh?
Such an aggressive, weird form of dancing. The gates are open. It's like a good living room dance, too, because you don't need a lot of space.
Gate one. I don't know the lyrics, but it's been pretty fun doing that and introducing chaos into the house. So... We've been doing that for quite some time now. But then,
I mean, yeah.
Then, once I get the merch store up and I got a little bit of a smile on my face, just a little smile. A very, very volatile, fragile smile.
Oh, wow.
The littlest thing.
Oh, wow.
Can set me the fuck off. Yeah,
I set your ass off.
And she set me off. And then I start to spiral. So then she comes back into the room with an early Christmas present.
Yeah.
What could that be?
Well, I didn't want to give it to you early, but you were being such a bitch. I thought I had to cheer you up.
Keep calling me a bitch. Keep calling me a bitch.
Bitch.
I'll show you, bitch. Bitch.
Bitch. It was Cameo. Do people know what Cameo is?
Cameo is something that I should be doing. No, I'm just kidding. But Cameo is something that, like,
it's like an OnlyFans, but no, yeah, like cocks and vaginas.
Well, I mean, if you're creative enough, you could probably do that. It's basically you pay people, stars, celebrities, whatever, sports guys,
you write
girls,
them a little note,
musicians. You give them a little bit of like, hey, it's Brad's birthday, and Brad likes tortillas.
Yeah, and they were,
and
you
he
know,
also likes The Big Bang Theory.
Oh,
so
ew,
if you wanna,
I hate Brad.
If you want to wish him a happy birthday and tell him go eat some tortillas and watch The Big Bang Theory.
Go eat The Big Bang Theory
and maybe give
dick.
Him a bazinga. I'll pay you $50.
That show sucks.
And people do that. So
sucks.
What did you do?
I requested a cameo several weeks ago from Tim Capello because you're fucking always turning those goddamn videos on, even though I tell you not to. It's like you love him and
love
it's
him.
Funny anyway. So I did it. And then you became a pain in my ass because of the smirch madness. And then
hey,
I didn't
Andrew,
even want to give it
how
to you.
How you doing there, brother?
Oh,
this is
him.
Tim Capello from Tina Turner's band and the Lost Boys. And anything else you want to throw out there?
This is my favorite.
He goes, Brother Andrew and Brother Lizzie. I don't know if you call me brother. I asked him for a dance lesson because I told him, I was like, we try, but we can't get that hip motion down.
What?
Yeah. And I asked him to play Simply the Best because I told him that Andrew is simply the best to
Hell
me.
Yeah.
And that was the corniest shit ever. And it was so good.
He loved it.
Well, because everybody asked him to play I Still Believe from the Lost Boys. And I was like, no, give me that Tina. Give me that Tina.
You're simply the best. Come on, clap your hands.
Clap your hands.
Oh, better,
that's my fucking guy.
Yeah, better than anyone.
This is for me.
Oh,
Christmas. You ready?
Watch out. Here come the hips now.
Here come the hips now.
Where is it? There it is.
Oh, shit. I love his laugh.
Merry Christmas, Andrew. Me and Lizzie want to wish you all the best. And until the day...
Oh, man.
And then he says we're going to meet up someday. So
he's going to beat my ass.
I have severe high hopes for hanging out with Tim Capello and his glistening hip ass cheek someday.
We still believe.
I still believe.
Bing, 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 bing. Anyways.
Yeah, so that happened.
And then you got me another gift.
Yeah. What was it?
We're going to see Devin Townsend again.
Because he was so upset and so whatever for so many days. I was like, I should just give him all the Christmas presents I got him already. That's smart. No, that's fucking dumb because now I have shit.
Yeah. Well,
I fucked myself over for your well-being.
Well, we met Devin at NAMM this year before the world went to shit.
my dumbass running up. Devin, you're the best. Simply the best. I may as well have done that, to be honest. That was so weird.
He seemed like he would have been used to it by now.
And what wasn't that weird? Just like,
no, he was actually pretty cool to talk to. And we had a nice conversation. But part of that conversation was like, hey, we can't wait to see you at the Metro. We actually got tickets.
That was in March of this year, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, we were supposed to go in March.
And then, literally the day before we were supposed, the day after, the day after Chicago announced they were closing everything was that Devin Townsend concert.
Yeah, we were supposed to go to with Al and Steph.
Shout out to the
Al, the Pied Piper of Crete.
Pied Piper of Crete.
Oh, I got this. And we're supposed to go with him and his wife. Mm-hmm. And we were texting them like for 2 days leading up. And we're like, what's going to happen? What is this? Should we go? Should we not go? Are you like nervous? What's going to happen? Is it going to get canceled? And from the beginning, you and I were both like, it's going to get canceled.
Yeah.
Straight up. Like, sure. We shouldn't even think we're going to go because we're not, because it's going to get. And then like what? 24 hours before? You shut down all music venues.
Yeah. And never opened up again. So then,
simply the best.
So then you bought me tickets to see Devin Townsend's live stream Christmas.
It's his Christmas special.
On what? December 23rd.
Yeah. And we invited Al and Steph
for a little watch party.
Hopefully they will come.
But if you guys haven't checked out his live streams, they're actually pretty cool, pretty
awesome.
Wait,
you've seen them?
What do you mean?
It says that these are not ever available.
I've seen videos. Him live stream like in the beginning of all this.
Oh, well, these have gotten like he's done a couple like full like ones on here and they say they don't post them anywhere. I don't know.
But I remember when he beginning of quarantine, he was doing live streams like him in his studio.
Yeah, no, this is like a bigger thing, I think.
Yeah.
Question though, what happens if someone records that?
I mean, how do you think we saw that Batushka live stream or the Behemoth
live
stream?
Yeah, that's what I just thought of.
The Down live stream. So they just post
it and then they wait for YouTube to fucking flag it? When?
Depends. I mean, I haven't seen.
Have you seen any of Devin?
No.
Okay, because he's, lists his concerts on there. He's had a couple.
Yeah.
Several, I think. So if you haven't seen any of those, maybe.
Well, those bands like put theirs out after.
We like the
so
the Behemoth one looked like not like recorded or whatever.
No, it was like pre-made.
Yeah, so they did that, right?
I mean, it was a live stream,
right? But then they wanted to release it.
Yeah, I think it's. I think they're actually doing like a.
I'm talking about somebody like sitting with their phone recording their fucking computer screen or whatever.
Well, that's what happened with the Down live stream. That's how I saw
that. I don't know anything about that,
but
Is that band from like Louisiana or something?
Yeah, New Orleans.
It's with
Phil Anselmo's band.
Follow Phil.
And Kirk Phil. Winstein and company.
FF. FP. Follow Phil.
And I was against live streams for the longest time, but it'd be nice to see, you know, some sort of music.
I just figured since we were supposed to see him in March, because that was your fucking Christmas present, one of them, from last year. That for this Christmas
we was that because I put on Meshuggah?
No, I bought this a long time ago before Meshuggah.
Yeah, no, I was watching I like old Meshuggah.
Well, because we've been trying to see fucking Devin and we met him in January and we were supposed to see him in March and I had already bought the fucking tickets for you for Christmas last year, which Christmas last year literally seems like it was like a month ago. This year went by so weirdly fast. I was like, well, at least maybe we can see that, like, hopefully everything opens back up and this is just, like, the last weird, like, live concert and it's his Christmas special. And I was like, why not?
The real question is, what instruments are going to come into this house for Christmas? Because last Christmas, oh, wait, was that your birthday?
No, that's what it was for my birthday. In May, you got me that instrument.
Oh, what did I get you for your birthday? What instrument?
Fuck, what's it called? It's a harp. Something.
It's a lap harp.
Lap harp. Is that a full lap hop harp or is that
lap
like a
hop?
Hop? Or is that the baby one?
I don't know. But
I think there's a special name because like All those things have like different...
I don't fucking know.
Well, you fucking should know before you fucking talk about it, okay?
I got you a lap harp.
Okay.
Because you want a real harp because somebody we've gotten to know very closely had a harp in her bedroom.
Yeah, we fucked a girl once.
All right.
Who had a harp in her bedroom.
And she played
and
it naked.
And I was like, oh, shit. I play the violin. But the harp has been like my dream. I was like, if I ever had kids, I would get a harp and make them play that while I ate dinner. I know that's fucking weird.
But would you have, no, wait, the kids play harp?
No, like that's my like life, like end goal, like that I would have children. They would learn to play the harp then they would play that while I ate dinner every night.
I was still talking about her playing it naked for us.
Oh, yeah. She played that naked for us. And then we both played it naked. And honestly, I think I was better at it than she was. But that's okay.
Hope she's doing all right.
No offense.
Anyways, so we got the lap harp. And we have some other instruments that are just...
When do we not have instruments?
In the house now.
Well, so we have your guitars. We have we have your oud. We have your oud.
Don't list the fucking instruments.
Oud. Oh, yeah. I got you an oud. What, 2 Christmases ago? Fuck, we're old.
I guess.
I got you that 2018? Your oud.
Yes.
Oud. And then I have my violin. We have a uke. We have the...
We don't need to list all the instruments.
Oh.
Anyways.
But the piano.
But we have some new instruments in the house. For gifts for other people, but we've been...
Well, did you mention the jiggery-joo?
The what?
Jiggery-joo.
The didgeridoo?
Jiggery-joo.
So, for those of you that have no idea what the hell she's talking about...
No one ever does.
Her dad, rest in peace, shout out to Larry, used to call the didgeridoo a jiggery-joo. I'm pretty sure that's what he thought it actually was.
Right? Yes.
Yes. It's an older man. Had no...
My sister's and her husband's neighbor was from Australia. My sister.
Australia.
And my dad liked him a lot. He like had come over here like in the last like 10 years or whatever. So he had full Australian accent, whatever. And my dad would ask him like, when you go back, because he would go back like twice a year to visit his family, bring me a jiggery-joo.
And he got one, and now
we
have
one. And so now we are the proud inheritors of a jiggery-joo.
Mm-hmm.
And
I think it was me, but okay. Okay. Okay.
Bitch, please. And so, yeah, I'm like a collector of instruments, and also I like to give them because they're so fun. So my niece and nephew, my niece is 10 and my nephew is 7. And so I got my niece.
17.
I don't fucking know. I got my niece. They live in Georgia. Did you hear that noise? That was my throat. I got my niece a mini kalimba.
Ooh.
Which is like this little like handheld like it has like steel like prongs on it. You play it with your thumb and it's sort of like a marimba, but like tiny, tiny. It's shaped like a cat because she loves cats. But if anybody wants a kalimba, I already learned how to play, what was it? Bohemian Rhapsody. It's not that hard. And then I also got my niece, who's 10, she plays piano, a melodica.
Now, what's that?
I don't know how to describe it.
It's like a piano.
It's like a little keyboard.
It's a keyboard that can only be played if you blow into it.
Yes.
So
it's really genius, honestly. I don't know how it works.
Oddly enough, of course, when we get these instruments, we open them up. So I had a lot of fun playing that thing. I was getting like some synth sounds on it, like some pulsators.
To be honest, I thought it was going to sound synthier. What do those people use when they do that on like the YouTube?
Synths?
Is it synths? Probably. So it needs to be like electrified and playing through the tube.
Yes.
Well, I don't know. It's a beginner. She's 10. She starts there. Whatever. It's pink.
And what did you get the 7-year-old?
I got my 7-year-old nephew a fucking accordion. It's so why cool.
Why would you get a child in an accordion?
I mean, to be honest, I was looking through like instruments and I thought that would be really cool.
No,
because you're telling me why did you get it? And I had no idea. So I don't know.
But
I
didn't know that. Dad.
Yes. Apparently my mom told me after I bought it and it was at our house that my dad always wanted my nephew to play the accordion. I did not know that. I randomly looked at instruments that were suitable for children on the internet and this little accordion was one of them. I didn't know my dad thought that. So I apparently got him an accordion and my dad wanted him to play the accordion. Who knew?
Because he loved Mexican music.
He really did. We're going to start a fucking with the melodica, your guitar, my violin, Austin's fucking accordion. We're going to start a mariachi band, as fuck my dad would have called it, a maharachi band, which incorporates the Middle Eastern. So we are just all set. We'll call it maharachi.
Saharachi.
You know he called them that. He didn't know how to say like maharachi.
I know. But
we should do that.
So we've been playing with these children's instruments.
They are legit.
Unbeknownst to them. We have to try them out. We're the professionals in the family.
Dude, there's so many cool instruments. The next one I want to buy that's like sort of expensive though is like a mini steel drum.
Okay.
No, they're really cool. And they have the little finger attachments and the mallets.
Sure.
Well, it's like $60. So it's like a little... Well, extra for like a
what else
mini
do you
instrument.
Want for Christmas?
Oh, I asked for baking pans.
Okay.
And a miter saw.
Cool. That's it. That's all you want for Christmas?
I mean, that's what I've asked for. I want to put crown molding up in one of our bedrooms that doesn't have it, so I need a miter saw.
Cool.
I'm fucking industrious. Whatever.
And I'm not.
No, you're not. I'm more handy than you, but that's okay.
That's because you haven't seen me be handy. Anyways, so that's all you want for Christmas. Cool. Well, we're obviously getting into the Christmas spirit here.
I just want people to be happy.
Yeah. Probably not going to happen.
I feel like Christmas is... I feel like it was just Christmas last year.
That's my
issue. Like, I haven't processed that it's Christmas again.
Because time hasn't been a thing since March.
We've been in Groundhog Day since March, which is, what, 3 months after fucking Christmas. So, like, yeah, like... We had it feels like it's been 3 months since the last Christmas, and that's reasonable. Because we only had 3 months normal after last Christmas.
But were they really normal?
I don't know. We went to California. Thank God we went then so I could see California for the first time
before it's on fire.
It shall never be the same.
Jesus.
Damn. Also, I really wish we had done some of the fucking, like, gone up to the forests and stuff that I wanted to, but whatever.
Oh, you hear that, everybody? She wanted to go to the forest when she didn't even want to go and do anything.
I wanted to go see, like, not the cities. I want to go, like, the Redwood Forest and stuff, but I'm sure it's still there.
It's still there.
Yeah.
You just can't go see it right now.
No, you can't be outdoors without a hazmat suit.
You could catch the vid in the forest.
Everybody's got the vid.
So it's obvious you've been getting into the Christmas spirit.
Well,
being that we are less than shit. We're 17 days away from Christmas.
I mean, I 17. Pretty much got... children, two of them, three musical instruments. I got you a cameo video from Tim Capello and a virtual concert. Yeah, I mean, so no.
Well, you've been doing your little bow action. You've been dressing up the house as well.
Yeah, but it doesn't seem fun this year.
No, it doesn't.
Even though I know like we're going to have like a small
get
Christmas
together
here, but it just is like weird. It's like I don't care. Like I put up our Christmas tree and I had this I don't know how to describe the mask.
It's like a masquerade.
It's like a masquerade mask from like it's of antique. It's from like the Victorian era. So it's like actually like the top half of a woman's face, like with the skin and everything, and the eyes are cut out like these tiny little holes, and she has hair and a Santa hat on. But it looks realistic. So when you put it on your face, like I have a similar like skin tone, so it literally.
How many times do you think people have banged with those masks on?
Dude, I don't know. Should we do it? I don't even know how to describe it. I don't think people could understand what those even look like.
Like swingers, I'm saying. Like old.
Well, swingers are already strangers, so what do they care?
I'm saying from back in the day. Because obviously they were like, oh, we can't. I don't want to see them.
Well, who knows? Because I got those at an estate sale from a house three blocks from here, so goddamn.
Hell yeah.
Who knows?
So many cum shots.
Who knows? Cum shoots.
But we also. So aside from you decorating the whole house while I try and get some sort of like Christmas merch going, we've also been dipping our toes into some Christmas movies to get into the spirit.
Krimbus.
And we also made a list of Christmas
per
movies.
Per your request, which was shocking.
Because we can't ever decide on Christmas movies to watch so every year.
We already watched what?
Chevy We've Chase. Watched Christmas Vacation.
That's my favorite.
Your favorite. We've watched Four Christmases because that's a given.
It's a good funny filler Christmas.
Reminds us of all of these movies. Sort of remind us of our own lives, which probably why we watch them. But the newest one. The newest addition to our.
I don't know if I can even talk about it.
The newest addition to our Christmas movie list. And quite honestly, probably one of my favorite Christmas movies.
Oh, fuck. We went there.
In the past, I don't know how long. Sorry, I'm getting some like swirling over there. Is the hit Mel Gibson movie, Fat Man. Holy shit.
Fat Man's Watching You.
For those of you that have no idea what I'm talking about, go to wherever you stream movies and go rent Fat Man featuring Mel Gibson.
It's indescribable.
It's fucking great.
It is great.
Don't watch it with your children, but it's fucking great.
But also, they should really have a better like description of the movie because people might do that and it's not a kid movie.
Yeah. Well, I mean, I don't want to give anything away, but if you don't get the gist of it from like the first 15 minutes, you should probably take our word for it and don't show your kids that movie. But if you willingly do that, then that's on you. But
Fat Man's Watching.
That's probably one of my favorite Christmas movies now. It's up there with Jingle All the Way.
I mean, I
knew Santa's Sleigh.
Oh shit. I knew it had to be good when it was Mel Gibson in a fucking Christmas movie where he plays Santa and the description mentioned the US military and I was like sold. I need to watch this now.
At first, I was like, what the fuck is this?
Dude, it's bizarre, though.
I remember when it first came out and people were talking about it because everyone was like confused. And then the other night, you're like, let's watch Fat Man. What is that? And I'm like,
You
heard
didn't want to watch it because you were busy. And I was like, you know what? I'm not looking for anything else. I'm putting on Fat Man.
And
we've watched a lot of Mel Gibson in the last few months. Patriot, Braveheart, Fat Man.
Ransom.
Mm.
Coming soon.
I want to watch Forever Young.
Shut
My
up.
My mom said we should watch that too.
What else is on our list? What other?
I didn't make the list. You have the fucking list.
What other tidbits are we going to give the listeners here? Some tips.
Jingle All the Way.
Jingle All the Way. Dutch.
Dutch. Ah.
Christmas Vacation. Home Alone 1 and 2.
Yeah, but never 3 or beyond.
What else is on our list? Per Your Request, Little Women. And you Lucy's. Like
what'd you put? Friday After Next. Wait,
shut up. Lucy's Christmas Special.
Yeah, it's 20 minutes long.
That's your yearly.
Suffer for 20 minutes.
Friday After Next.
Yeah,
of course that's mine. Santa's Sleigh. Thank you very much. Four Christmases, Christmas with the Cranks. That's a solid choice.
It actually
choice.
Is a good movie.
That's such a good movie. Elf, is that on our list?
Yeah, can I exchange that for something else?
No.
I feel like when you saw Elf once, you don't need to see Elf again.
Suffer.
You suffer.
What else is on the list?
I don't know, because you took the list.
Shit. Well, yeah. You can start with those.
That's all I remember.
And work your way around.
I'm sure there were more, but...
Yeah, we did, 15 Christmas movies on the list? So we figured we'd count down to Christmas. And I know a lot of you that listen to the band are probably like, that's not black metal.
Eat shit. Sorry.
No, I'm kidding.
We have to fucking work with what we've got right now.
Yeah, man. It's been a fucking shitty year.
And if a Christmas movie makes you feel good to round out the year, you should fucking watch whatever trash you want.
Yeah.
Or if you want to watch porn all day.
Christmas porn.
Do it. Oh, my God. Oh, fuck. I have a thing to add to the list.
Christmas porn?
No. Fucking Skinamax, Showtime, Softcore, like the Christmas movies. They're out now. Fuck, we have to look.
Obviously.
Dude, those are the best. I love some Skinamax.
No doy.
I forgot about that. We used to watch the Halloween ones. I don't think we've ever watched Christmas ones. We're doing that tonight.
No.
Yeah.
No.
Why?
Because.
I want to watch their parts not connect when they're fake fucking.
It's like they're... No, not even.
It's more of like a soft.
And glistening balloon tits.
I still believe.
Glistening balloon tits and like glistening male ass.
Yes. Just
fucking.
And he's like fucking her abdomen.
Yeah. Yeah.
Dude, we need to see the Christmas ones.
That'll be on the XXXmas list. Fine. Well, in that case, it'd probably be XXmas list. But anyways. But.
Yeah, I mean, if you need to round out the year with some good Xmas movies.
Yeah, it's crazy. The year is almost over.
It felt like we only had 3 months, which makes sense.
I'm pretty excited for everyone.
What?
Near Christmas time to start saying, oh,
don't even. Don't.
2020 is finally over.
I've already started hearing it. Oh my God, I'm so ready to be done with 2020. What's going to happen on January 1st? Is a miracle going to happen? No. Every day is going to keep going on as it has.
Until we change
it. And then you know what people are going to say? Oh my God. It's 2021. And somehow they're going to find a way to make 2021 worse than 2020.
They've already started to say that. What if 2020 is just the beginning of like... The worst decade.
Oh, wow.
Yeah.
Yeah, so people, oh my God, 2020 is so hard. Yeah, January 1st, bitch, talk to me then. It's going to be the same life, the same living situation, the same everything that you've created for yourself, to be honest with you.
Yeah, it's like...
Don't get me started.
It's like karma has manifested itself into all of our lives.
But I still believe.
All right. 2020 is finally over. No, I'm just kidding.
I've been cut off because 2020 is ending.
Yeah.
I'm glad when 2020... You know what's weird, though, is like for work and stuff, like typing 2021 is like a fucking mind fuck.
Well, that's because time is a human construct.
Time isn't real.
No shit.
It's stupid.
And on that note, we're out of time.
Oh, fuck. We should have talked about Ethiopia.
Go ahead.
Okay. Fine.
Is this a fact or is this an alternative fact?
This is an actual fact.
Do we need a fact checker?
Suck my dick. Ethiopia.
Ethiopia.
Works on a different calendar than we do. So there are more days in a month or there's like an extra month or something. That is, I don't know which one that is. But because they have extra days in their year, Ethiopia is like 7 fucking years behind us. Okay. So if I, for example, I'm 31. What's 7 years minus that?
I don't know, 26.
So
no.
In
24.
Yeah, 24. So in Ethiopia, wow, right now, someone born in 1989 mm-hmm. is like 24, 25 years old.
Sounds
this
like
is fucking true. And for business, hey, they like for business, they have to like adapt for if they're doing business with other countries. So like they have to like configure the year and stuff like that. But literally people who live in Ethiopia think that it's 2012 or 13 right
so,
now.
So what you're saying is.
So I am 25.
24.
Okay, I'm 24.
So what you're saying is.
Time is bullshit.
That and the right age to go for is 25-year-olds. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, I don't know. But somebody should...
18 in our world. No, I'm just kidding.
Imagine, though, if we just had a few extra days in each year, we would be that much...
Behind?
Like, younger.
It doesn't matter.
So fucking
it literally
weird.
Doesn't, it literally doesn't
No, it
matter.
Actually does matter for like social stuff and like... Yeah, it does. I don't know. That's like thinking
I
about
mean,
that.
I mean, if you're 25 years old and you feel like a 31-year-old, does that really
but
matter?
But how would you, why would you ever, if you grew up in that timeline and that calendar, how would you ever feel that you were 31? You'd be like, why would I feel like I was 31?
You would think that turning 25 sucks. Just like I'm sure
straight
that
up
people
thought turning 25 sucked. Just like I thought.
Oh, whatever. Get over it.
31 sucked.
I'm sure people that like, you know, like we hear statistics of like so and so year olds or, you know, they can't get pregnant anymore, and we're like, oh my god. But like over there, it's like, yeah, they're just like what 40 years old.
Yeah, I don't know.
You know what I mean, like.
It's just weird.
Like, we probably hear, like, but, like, oh, imagine, they're getting pregnant at this age. But then, like, over there, they're like, hey, this person is actually 18.
But think about having that much more time in 1 year to complete, like, a school year or, like, you know, study. I don't know.
Yeah. I don't know.
Whatever. I was just throwing it out there.
Time.
People should look it up.
All that does is you're just proving my point that time is just.
No, that was my point.
It's my point.
Eat shit.
And live.
I love you.
You love yourself.
Wow.
I still believe.
On air. Wow. Ba, ba, ba.
Ba, 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 ba. I love you too.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Tim Capello. Get that hip. Oh, I still believe.
All right. So.
You had already stopped it, didn't you?
Nope. I think that about wraps it up for part 16 of the Lizard and the Wizard podcast special, quarantine special. We should have one more before the year's end, and maybe we'll have a little bit more of an update on what the lizard wants for Christmas other than pans and a saw. But who knows?
Last year I wanted a drill and a Dutch oven. Nothing has changed. I use all that shit all the time.
Yeah. And maybe we'll get into some of the movies we watched And maybe it's a little too early to call, but maybe we'll talk about this new season of 98 Day Fiancé.
Because it's simply the best.
So far, episode 1, season 8. All right. You've got our attention after that shit show of that last Other Way season.
They have my major attention.
We said before we're not going to talk about them anymore, but we'll give you a couple more shots. So maybe we'll have more to talk about in general on the next episode. But it's about that time we wrap it up.
Adios, muchachos and muchachas. You're simply the best. Better than all the rest.
All right, so that about wraps it up for this episode. Again, thank you for listening. I hope you enjoyed this episode. If you did enjoy this episode, please check out the episodes before it, whether it's the Lizard and the Wizard podcast or just the solo podcast. As I said before, we're going to be switching things up with the second year of this podcast. So stick with me. And again, apologies for losing my voice and not being able to put out an episode last week. But hey, we're doing this. We're going live and you're listening. So either way, I appreciate you for sticking around. With that, please like or please subscribe to the podcast if you can. Every bit helps. Please rate the podcast, comment on the podcast. Literally every engagement helps, especially while social media is basically silencing all of us at the moment, just in general, like even you. So as you can imagine, the reach for anything creative is brutalized at the moment. So I don't know. I'm just rambling. It's been a tough week. It's been a very, very tough week, but I'm happy that I was able to talk to you all here at the Manor. And if you want to join in on the fun, the mischief, magic, and mystery, head to our Facebook group while Facebook is still a thing. And join our Facebook group strictly for the podcast. This podcast doesn't have like a website or anything. So what I've been doing is just opening up the forum for all that want to join in and ask questions or just chime in on stuff, whatever. So please subscribe to the please subscribe to the podcast. Rate the podcast, comment on the podcast, whatever. And feel free to join our Facebook group at facebook.com/groups/the6mpodcast. Okay. And being that this show has no sponsors at the moment, this show is sponsored by me. And since it's me, I'm going to talk about Serpents US, as I am the singer guitarist of Serpents US. And there's a few things I got to talk about. Okay. Few things. Number one, we dropped an ass load of new merch, as I talked about on this episode. It took me literally, I know I didn't talk about it with the Lizard, but it took me literally from waking up to pretty much going to sleep for a week to do this merch drop just in time for the holidays. Granted, I missed out on all the fun little tagline days, Bandcamp Friday, Cyber Monday, whatever. But it's out there and it's live. So if you can go to our Bandcamp at weareserpents.bandcamp.com, at least go give our new merch a gander. We got new shirts, we got new long sleeves, we got new hoodies, we got new kids merch, baby merch. We got face masks, we got koozies, and we got sweat. We even got a sweatsuit in there. You hear that? We got a sweatsuit in there. We got hats, we got beanies, we got it all, okay? This is a DIY operation, so you could imagine how hard it was to pull off a drop as big as that. So we really could use the support. That is, if you are a fan of the band. And if you're not, go check us out, will you? Come on. So we have that, and basing how this drop goes, I believe we might do like a one new item a week before Christmas. I have some winter items that I was too nervous to sell because I wasn't sure if people were going to buy anything due to the pandemic, quote unquote pandemic, or just the fact that we're all out of work at the moment. I was just trying to be polite and not, ask for any sales all year. But at this moment, I'm going to ask your guys' help. Please go pick up some merch if you feel the need. And if you don't have any cash to spare this year, this holiday season, number one, that stuff will still be available. Number two, if you don't have any money, you can still help us out. Head to Spotify. Go follow us on Spotify. Not just listen to us. Obviously, go listen to us. Obviously. But give us a listen at Serpents US. Follow us. I'm going to be doing my yearly best of list. The band, I believe, is going to be coordinating their top 50, top 25 lists of the year as well. New Serpent Society playlist is now live with all my favorite tracks from November. It's a monthly playlist. So every month, like, I know I do the podcast, I do the vlogs, I do the band, obviously. But I also try and spread the good word of any bands that are releasing new good music. It's my way of giving back to the community as little as it is. So it would always be helpful to have some, some support on that front as well. It does take a long, long, long time doing that stuff, at least with some sort of merit, right? You just don't want to throw stuff into a playlist and call it a playlist. So, new merch, Spotify. And as always, guys, YouTube is a thing at the moment. So we're not touring. We're not doing anything like real bands do at the moment. So if you guys can head to our YouTube at youtube.com/user/WeAreSerpents, go check out our videos. I got some live streams from the last week or so posted up there. I went live on IG. We're going to be going live on YouTube and live on Twitch. Not playing games, just playing music and answering questions and talking. So either way, if the podcast isn't your thing, head to YouTube. If watching anything isn't your thing, then go listen to the music or do all of the above or do none. I don't know. If you've listened this far, I appreciate you for listening. I appreciate your support. And I truly hope that you find some sort of goodness in some of these things that I've created for you this year. So I hope you guys have a good week. Stay safe. Stay sane.